Hello and what is up YouTube, it is your boy Mr. Belly Elliot here, bringing you a brand new YouTube video this week. And today we are opening the booster box of Matchless Fighters. Now this is the latest Pokemon set to arrive in the UK from Japan. And as you know, if you have watched videos on this channel, I am a massive fan of opening Japanese Pokemon cards. So guys, before we get into that though, thank you for your continued support over on here and the Twitch channel. Check the links in below so you can check out all the Mr. Belly Elliot entertainment that you can. But without further ado, let's get in and open this Matchless Fighters box. Okay, so here we have the Matchless Fighters booster box. Did arrive the other day from Japan. Well, we're going to go in and open it. Now, this is possibly one of my favourite looking sets. I've seen some of the cards that are in this set, and I must say, they are amazing. The Blaziken alternative art is amazing. All of the birds. The birds look amazing as well. Obviously, you've got Moltres, Zapdos, and Articuno. In this sort of Galar form, as it were. There is the pack out there. Only 5 cards in these packs, but I'm hoping to get the artworks of all of those. But this is effectively the Isle of Armor and the Crown Tundra DLC from Pokemon Sword and Shield. In the latest reincarnations in the cards. So without further ado, we are going to just jump in and get into this booster box. As always, there are some nice easy packs to open. I've got my sleeves ready, so hoping for some amazing pulls here. Here we go. So we got, forgotten his name, it's Farfetch'd, Sobble, Hatina, Sharpedo, and that one. No idea what that one's called, but we are, just like I said, just gonna plow through. There are only five cards in a pack to open, so it shouldn't take too long. You got Cubfu. Look at that beautiful Heracross card there. Shout out Uncertified Fire, I know how much you love Heracross. Woobat, Urshifu into that guy. Again, some of these names are going to escape me, as always with Japanese cards. If you don't speak Japanese, then you sort of have to know your Pokemon. Like that one. No idea. No idea. No idea. That's the tree where the birds do go and hang out at Crown Tundra into. A Galarian Sirfetch'd there, I do believe, because he does have the shield with him. So I said five cards per pack, and we are literally just going to burn through. Now I do mention a lot in my videos how much I love the Japanese packs, and the artworks. That's a trainer, and this is no doubt anything different. Japanese cards for me are just beautiful. I mean, the way they sort of, they're packed and designed is just amazing. That's the Happy Christmas Pokemon. Oh, there we go. Slowking VMAX. That's one of the cards I wanted to pull into a horn. I'm gonna go ahead and sleeve this one up. Look at that. That is like the dark wizard form of Slowking. Is it Slowking? I think it's Slowking. It's Slowking, but with like the magician gap. So we have got the VMAX of that. So that is our first pull of the video. Unsure as how many packs I've opened now, but like I said, we are just gonna go ahead and keep flying through because there are a lot of packs to open in this. And I know that my Pokemon bulk is just going to increase. Obviously with the amount of cards in here, but there are some amazing artworks. Weedle, chilling above a hair across there. Don't know if you can see that. Surfetched into Houndour. But let me know, guys, down in the comments if you have opened any Matchless fighters yourself. And what was your favorite pull? Or what is a pull you're hoping to see today on this channel? And hopefully we can get there and smash it. Thunderous holographic there. I'm going to sleeve it up because it is a holo. I'm going to sleeve it up. Just so we've got something to show for ourselves for good pulls. Because at the moment we've got that Slowking holo. Slowking VMAX even. But we do want obviously get some better pulls than that. Diglett. I don't know a lot of these poke. Oh! Articuno V-card. Look at that. The pulls are starting to come out. They're starting to come out. The sun will out. And so are the pulls. Come on. Like I said, just burning through these packs. Only get 5 cards per pack. So I'm eager to see what we can get in those packs. So Diglett. Honestly, that's like Venipede or something. That's a doggy. Oh, and we've got the Slow King V there as well. So we both got the V and the V Max. Look at that. Gorgeous card. Gorgeous card. Now that's one of the cards I want to get. And the fact they got the V card and the V Max card in the same box is amazing. So happy with that. That's the little shark. Heracross again. That's again a beautiful card. Spiritomb into a trainer card there. Like I said, my Pokemon knowledge isn't up to scratch. So a lot of these names are escaping me. But Weedle, Larvitar. There is a holographic Inteleon there, followed by a Hatterene. Look at that. Again, it's a holo, so it gets a sleeve. So we are starting to burn through some of these sleeves as the pulls are coming out. So we've got Articuno, just need Moltres and Zapdos. And then we've sort of got the birds as a set. Oh, Urshifu holographic. Look at that. Look at the colours on that. It sort of looks like an amazing rare with the background colours. But unfortunately, it's not. I don't believe that there is any amazing rares in this set. But it's always fun to know ahead of the game, which I didn't. I didn't have to do a lot of research into this set. I've opened a lot of Japanese sets now. Look at that Beedrill holographic. Look at that. I have opened a lot of Japanese sets. I did Rapid Strike on the channel. I did Single Strike on the channel. The Shiny Star V. I've done Legendary Heartbeat. I've done Tag Team All-Stars. And I don't know, I never not enjoy opening Japanese cards because they are just so beautiful to look at. Is that Hatterena? Hatterena? Hattery something? Harry Potter in a lovely little hat there. And I always, like I said, I always love opening Japanese cards just because the way they're presented is amazing. Oh, look at that Dugtrio into the horn. Now, that's not a holo, but if it was, it would be a very majestic card there. So I'm not sure how many packs we get in this booster box. I want to say it's possibly 30. But not entirely sure. But we are, like I said, we are just burning through. Nice and easy for you there. Just so we can keep this video nice and short for you guys. But like I said, you know, in the comments, let me know what you guys think of the Japanese cards. Are you a fan? Have you opened any yourself? Oh, look at that Blaziken V. If only that was the alternative art. The alternative art is a card I want. Blaziken is like ripping through the city. It's a beautiful car, but look at that. Another amazing pull. As I was saying, what is your opinion on Japanese cards? Do you like them? If you could easily get hold of stock, would you buy them more over the English cards? Let me know, because I really like... Oh my gosh! Look at that. Oh. This is like my third ever rainbow card I have pulled in my time opening Pokemon cards. Look at that. The Slowking VMAX, but it is rainbow. We have pulled every single Slowking card in this set in one video. I can. That is something else. Oh. For one of the chase cards that I wanted, I'm so happy to have that. I'm so happy. Like I said, that was my third ever rainbow card that I've ever pulled. And you know what? I'm over the moon. This Matchless Fighters box is, so far, one of the best Japanese boxes I've opened, in my opinion. And I only wish that I knew the names of some of the Pokemon inside. Some of them I know, some of them I don't. But the Slowking, I am extremely happy about that. Because the moment I saw that sort of variant on the Crown Tundra, I just knew I had to go and find those twigs and get it. Oh! Hello! That's the Sarcophagus Pokemon, I believe. I'm probably wrong, but it's a holo. It is a glorious holo, so we'll take that. If only now I could get some of the alternative artworks for the birds, I'd be really happy. I'd be really, really happy. But look, there is another holographic there. Again, the name escapes me. The name escapes me, but the pulls in this video so far, they are absolutely flying up. Now, I did toy with the idea a few weeks back of doing a live box break over on Twitch for you guys to sort of, you know, buy a pack and then watch me open them for you on stream. Now, potentially, obviously, it's going to be a Japanese box because they're more fun to open, I'd say. But would you guys be interested in partaking in a box break? Let me know in the comments and I'll see what I can organize, because like I said, that I know I say it a lot, but I do really enjoy opening Japanese cards. So let me know. I mean, if it was a Japanese set like this, oh, Blaziken VMAX. Oh, the pulls in this video are never ending. Look at that beautiful card. Wow. Let me know, guys, down below in the comments. More than likely, it will be a Japanese box. Packs will be around £2.50, £3, including postage. And you can buy as many packs as you like. And we'll open them on stream. Just something for, you know, our little community to enjoy together, a little event. Let me know what you guys think. And let me know any Japanese sets you want to sort of take part in. Come on, Sobble's crying. Oh, Zapdos. Zapdos V. Come on. All we need now is the Moltres, and we've got all three birds as well. Going in to last pack magic. It was a nice little rub. There we go. Last pack magic. For what has been an amazing video. The pulls. Wow. Let's just say the pulls for me personally have been amazing. Come on. Come on. Ah. No. We end on the Kakuna. But guys, can we just recap the pulls we have got? Because I am blown away by the pulls. So we've got Zapdos, Blaziken VMAX, that thing, the other thing, the Slowking Rainbow card, Blaziken V, Harry Potter, Beedrill, Urshifu, Inteleon, Slowking V, Articuno V, Thundurus, and the Slowking VMAX. Let me know what you think of these pulls, because I think they're absolutely stunning, guys. And that is it. That is the end of the video. Thank you so much, as always, guys, for coming along and watching me open these cards. Apologies for not knowing all of the names of the Pokemon. I only wish I did, because then the content would be 100% for you. But like I said, if you would be interested in partaking in a box break on my Twitch channel, let me know down in the comments below and I'll see what we can do. But until next time, guys, thank you so much for watching. It means a lot. I've been Mr. Bell Elliott, and you've been great. Thank you. Bye-bye.